Welcome back to Extreme Playgrounds. I'm Tom Conman Connors, professional street basketball player and multi-Guinness World Record holder. Let's have a look at what's coming up on today's show. So I'm here in the famous South Bank in London. This place has seen some of the best urban sports talent in the UK, including this guy.
Hi, I'm 360. I'm a professional BMX rider from Bournemouth in England. I started riding because of my brother, really. He's also a professional BMX rider. I used to do some other extreme sports, but my brother bought me a bike and told me I had to ride, and sort of I did, and I enjoyed it, and therefrom out, I've carried on for 8 years now. BMX is itself, it's a fun enjoyment sport. It's just fun with your friends, and I've been lucky enough for it to take me around the world and do the things that I do with it. My first sort of major trip was probably something simple, an X up, which is kind of just where you cross the bars like that. But it's just like sort of a basic learner trick, and then you just go from there, really. If you want to learn the hard tricks, you've got to be prepared to fall. You don't game without falling every now and then. It's part of it. Luckily, in England now, they've got a lot of foam pits and resi ramps for people to learn on, which sort of helps you out a little bit, so you don't have to go straight to a hard landing. You've got the nice soft landings, and you just work your way up and carry on. My advice to youngsters sort of trying to get into BMX is, there's a lot of them that start scootering and some progress onto BMX. It's sort of like an entry level, but it's daunting at the start. It doesn't all come straight away. You just keep practicing, keep enjoying it, and it'll come naturally. And you sort of want to get into riding BMX, one of my first tricks was an X-up. So it's going to give you a little run through on how to do it. What you do is you sort of gain off something that's sort of flat, just so you can get sort of about a foot or two of height. But sort of you come out, lean back a little bit so your bars don't hit your leg. And you just lean back, push your right. Some people go that way, some people go that way. Personally, I go to the right. So I cross my arms through. When you get the X, it stops you and you pull it back. Make sure you pull it back because it's going to hurt. Go you sort of an X up out here, and you sort of get a gist of it.
so this place might actually get torn down. Now I'm here to meet a guy called Henry. He's in charge of saving this iconic place.
Behind me is the oldest surviving skateboard spot in the world. It's been skated since 1973. For the British skate scene, this is basically the central hub. It's where everyone in the country comes down to meet one another. So many top professionals have been born here. I mean, there's some skating behind me right now, the likes of Chewy Cannon, Benny Fairfax, Tom Penny used to skate down here. In the 80s and 90s, like, we had teams from America coming over, like Natas Coopers, Mark Gonzalez. Basically, this is like, you know, the centre of the British skateboard scene. It's the most famous and the oldest surviving skate spot in the world. And it basically nurtures the new talent. There's always new generations coming through, learning from the old ones. And what's important about it is that you don't have to pay to come here. It's not like in football, you know, like a kid having a kickabout in a park. David Beckham's not just going to rock up and, you know, have a little kickabout. Like here, young kids get to come and skate with like their idols, with you know, famous skateboarders from across the world. So it's a really, really unique space, and it's really important that we preserve this for future generations.
So I'm going to teach you guys a basketball move called the carousel. This is not easy, it's going to take some practice, and this is how you do it. So, basketball on your head, use your right arm and your left arm to keep the basketball on your head. Now you're going to go into a 360, keeping your arms where it is, and this is how you do it. That is called the carousel. It's not easy. Practice, practice, practice. Give it a go. Coming up next is the UK and European BMX Flatland Champion. This guy's won 4 UK titles in a row and 2 in Europe. He's dominated BMX for years. I'd like to introduce you to Total.
My name is Keelan Total Phillips. I'm a professional BMX rider. Been riding now for probably 15 years. I ride what's called flatland BMX, otherwise known as freestyle BMX, which is just the art of doing tricks on the ground, like rolling positions or spins without the aid of any ramps. So there's a lot of creativity that goes into it, and a lot of energy, which hopefully you'll see in the videos. Yeah, I first got into BMX when my older brother used to ride around with his mates on this real crappy BMX, and I thought, you know, you're always jealous of what your older brother's got. And he eventually gave it to me, and I thought it was the best thing. And he used to just go around on the streets, just hopping off curbs, trying all these little things, and it just literally never stopped. I used to just love it. I'd out every night after school, all weekend, started learning more and more tricks, and then I started to enter competitions, and I'd do really bad, but even though I did so bad, at the competitions I'd think, oh, this is the best thing, I just want to learn more and more and more. And as I started to learn more, I did better at competitions, and it's just gone from there. I haven't stopped. One of my first tricks was just literally riding along on both wheels and just turning the handlebars, doing like a half bar spin, then a full bar spin, and then you can pick the front end up and do a full bar spin, that kind of thing. Those are like the first bits. But the main first tricks that I was really happy with is a trick called a hang five, which is on the front wheel, you roll along, and you're not using a front brake to keep up, so it's pure balance. And it's a trick that's used in sort of, you know, a lot of professional tricks. And to learn that for me was just like a massive stepping stone. It was a big boost. It took me ages to learn it. And once I got it, I thought it was the best thing. And yeah, it links to so many other tricks, so it's really helpful. And I recommend everyone to get out there and start to learn hang fives. Yeah, so some advice if you're getting into freestyle BMX or any kind of BMX is to, you've got to learn a lot of the basics. I wouldn't recommend to take off your brakes straight away. That's just a personal choice. When your riding develops, and you can sort of have that choice if you want to keep brakes or not. But one big thing, and this is really probably the most important thing, is try and be creative. So try and do a little, even if it's something really little that someone else hasn't done, just stick with that. Keep doing things that haven't been done and try and just be different from everyone else, then you'll stand out and that'll get you a long way in BMX.
Total.
What's going on, you alright?
Nice to meet you, my friend.
There's your bike for the day.
Right, slightly a bit worried about this one because I haven't been on a BMX since I was about 3.
You'll be fine.
Right, okay, so how long have you been riding a BMX for?
I've been riding now for about 15 years.
It's 15 years,
a long
wow.
Time.
Okay, so bearing in mind I haven't been on a bike for a long time, is this something that you can teach me that's sort of, you know, quite easy that people can pick up at home?
Yeah, for sure, yeah. So on the BMX bike, you get these things called pegs, which you can grind or stand on. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you a trick, stand on the pegs, and then hopefully you can let go of the handlebars.
Okay,
well.
So I'm stood on the front, on the back, and my hands go out.
That's the one.
Right, okay, do you wanna show us how it's done?
So, one foot on the back, okay. Push off, lock that knee, and you can get no hands.
Okay, it looks easy.
Looks easy,
okay, so back
peg. It's
not
too bad.
Okay, so back peg.
Right. And
oh, almost.
Close. Close.
Not
a little
bad.
Bit faster.
A little bit faster, so I'll try again. Okay, so.
Yes. Got it.
Yes, alright, okay. Well, I did that one. So have you got something a little bit more difficult? So you can try and show us?
We'll step up a little notch. So on this one, I want you to lay the bike on the floor, pick it back up, ride away. Right, so you're not allowed to step off the bike.
I've got to be on the bike all the time.
That's it.
Right, okay. Show us how it's done.
This is the one. Foot on top, you're going to lay it down, pick it up, ride away.
Okay. Okay. All right, so riding. So the bike goes down?
Yeah.
Oh, one more go, one more go. Okay, and then pick it up.
All the way up.
I don't think BMX is for me. I'm going to leave it to the professional. Total, take it away, my friend.
Cool.
We'll be right back. So there you have it, guys. My time in London is over. I've met with some of the world's best urban sports stars. I've had an incredible time. I've tried my hand at learning some football freestyle with AR, some street dance with Tricks and Showtime. I've learned some beatboxing with Fozzy and Shakes, and I've even tried my hand at some BMXing. I'm definitely not going to be giving up basketball anytime soon. I've been Tom Conman Connors, and you've watched Extreme Playgrounds. Thanks very much for tuning in.